two categories that most modern men fall in: stupid or foolish.
You got derision, you got anger, you got a woman, a jealous woman chasing you around, and an STD. She doesn't appreciate you, sir. She's got you babysitting her kids while she's going out all night. She's wondering why you can't be more of a father to the children she created with other men.
Kobe Bryant and his wife of 10 years, Vanessa, are kicking off 2012 with one of Hollywood's biggest divorce settlements.
Shalom, I'm KAHANTAZADAQ, a spokesman for men and women that love them. Share this video, make it go viral. If you are a man and you're about to engage in a long-term relationship, this is to encourage you not to get married until you've known that woman for at least 2 to 3 years. And do not impregnate her until the same time frame, or you will end up a victim of divorce rape like many of the men that you will see in this video. And if you are a woman and you think this is trivial, that it can't happen to you, if you have sons, that is a way of your son being divorce rape, laughing it off and thinking that it's trivial. I encourage you
to know why she can't get more of your money. When she's got a couple of child support checks coming in, she's got housing, she's done a disability check, and she wants to know why you can't part with more of your check.
We as men need a revolution of our minds, right? What kind of rational man engages into a contract that's about 85% one-sided against him? Take, for instance, the marital contract. 50% of all marriages end in divorce. Then you add to that the people that's not married. There's a high percentage of them not happy, right? And they end up broken up, right? So a man is literally going into a marital contract with about 85% chance of it not working and him losing half of his substance and then having to bring a bag to pay tribute.
I encourage you to share, like, and subscribe. Comment in the comment section. If you are a victim of this, reach out to KAHANTAZADAQ. He can help you with child support, child custody. He's been victorious himself. He's helped many other people, and he could help you. A spokesman for men and women that love him. This is Taza Doctrine.
Settlements. With Bryant's net worth an estimated $150 million, Vanessa could walk away from the marriage with upwards of $75 million. And that's not all she's scoring. According to the LA Times, property records show that the couple's three mansions, worth $18.8 million total, have already been transferred to Vanessa's name.
What kind of shit is that?
I think it's fair to say that this is a huge win for Vanessa Bryant. I mean, this woman is getting $75 million in cash right now. She's getting three properties in Newport Beach, California. I mean, after 10 and a half years of marriage, she's cleaning up pretty well.
Not a weasel word used for hyperbolic reasons. Divorce rape is a real phenomenon, and it's a crime perpetrated by the state against men, with trivial exceptions.
Group of men who will be paying their ex-wives probably till the end of their lives.
Michael Jordan's wife Juanita netted $168 million after their marriage of 17 years ended in 2006. Ela Nordegren recently tore down her $12 million mansion after reportedly pocketing $100 million after separating from husband Tiger Woods.
Divorce rape is a real phenomenon, and it's a crime perpetrated by the state against men, with trivial exceptions.
And just last month, Mel Gibson's wife Robin walked away from their marriage of nearly 30 years with an astonishing $425 million, which is considered to be the biggest divorce payout in Hollywood history.
Every guy you met's been trying to fuck you. That's right. Women are offered dick every day. Every woman in here gets offered dick at least 3 times a week.
Divorce rape is a real
stupid for getting married, foolish for having children in this society. I know you dudes feel me, man. So I'm talking to some of you right now. I'm talking to somebody right now, and you're shaking your head like he's right, but I hate the way he's saying it. So wear that, man. and get a revolution.
Rape is a real phenomenon, and it's a crime perpetrated by the state against men, with trivial exceptions.
3 times a day! Shit! That's right! Every time a man's being nice to you, all he's doing is offering dick. That's... Well, give him money. I want my money.
If you have a bank account, right, simply take all your money out of that bank account and close it, okay? You should not have a bank account if you are on child support. Why? Because having a bank account makes the fight harder, because that's another mechanism that they can use to enforce the support order, such as sending the bank a letter stating that they want to garnish your wages for back child support.
But remember, no court has the legal authority to mandate support for non-biological children. Moving on.
Imagine being told to pay child support for a kid that is not yours or go to jail. That was the order the state handed down to a Detroit man.
So today, he turned himself in.
Carnell Alexander walked into the Frank Murphy Hall of Justice knowing in moments he could lose his freedom.
I stayed up all night, couldn't sleep, thinking about it.
Carnell is a wanted man because he refuses to do what the state orders and pay child support for a child that DNA tests prove isn't his. A child who doesn't even know.
I haven't even had a chance to really speak to him except for one time when we took the DNA test.
What kind of shit is that?
Nonetheless, right now, under the law, he's a deadbeat dad. Today, he turned himself in to the judge as ordered.
Scared, because I've been before this judge before.
But this time, he had attorney Cherica Harris, who volunteered to help after seeing his story on 7 Action News. The judge said he will not go to jail for today.
Thank you. Thank Ms. Harris.
Hell no!
Though the threat of jail is on hold, it is not over. Carnell Alexander still owes more than $30,000 to the state for a child that's not his, because the mom wrote his name down because she needed to name someone in order to get welfare benefits.
Hell no!
And I had to put him down as the father. That was the only way I could get the sister.
Now,
what kind of shit is that?
I'm almost homeless. I'm almost in jail. I'm out of work. My money is being threatened to be taken.
Which, by the way, very convenient that she'll accept the child support payments from him as dad, but then when he actually wants to spend time with the child as a dad, no, he can't.
Classic.
What kind of shit is that?
Carnell isn't just worried about how this is impacting him. He says the law needs to be changed, so when this happens, as it often does, other men don't become dad by default.
Anyway, the Department of Revenue overturned the judge's decision and insisted that he continue to pay for this child who is not his and he has no visitation rights.
We can be defaulted into being a father of a child that is not ours. I don't understand that law, but it is a law in place.
What kind of shit is that?
Well, Chris, unfortunately, it's the kind of ish that happens every day. I would like to give you some comprehensive right knowledge on titles to your sons and daughters that the state refers to as children, how to handle things privately in judges' chambers, and overstanding contract law. As I previously stated at the inception of this video, I can be referred to as the authorized representative of KAHANTAZADAQ, the paramount security interest holder. I hold all the interest and collateral to all the property registered and unregistered belonging to the debtor defendant, KAHANTAZADAQ. I'd like to help all men that have actually been victims of child support and child custody. And if you fail to listen, you will end up a victim being divorced rate, or at least a victim of child support and not being able to see your son or your daughter.
This is all I got. This is all I got. Don't take my baby, okay? I've been away from my baby for 2 months. I just want my baby. I just want my baby.
If you meet a woman and all she talks about is how all of her exes are pricks, run. That's a red flag being waved at you. And if you're smart, you would detach and leave and never contact her again. I've said this to many young men, but they fail to listen and they end up victims and they come back, oh yeah, Ak, you was right. Hindsight's always 20/20 for people that inherently blind at the inception of an entanglement.
I just want my baby and no one's listening because no one's in the courtroom. I'm not doing anything illegal. I'm not doing anything illegal, but I don't want nobody. Oh my God, am I doing something illegal by doing this video, or is this, am I protected by the First Right Amendment or the amendment?
If you have funds in any type of financial institution, bank, credit union, I will highly encourage you for educational purposes only to remove that. And by the way, let me get my mantra. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel and then please be advised. What I'm about to provide you is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. I encourage you to listen to this video a minimum of 5 times because repetition is the father of learning. You have to listen again and again to get it. Primarily, you should really listen to it 10 times because research has shown that we only retain approximately 10% of what we hear in seminars or what have you for the first time. That means within a week, we don't even retain 10%. So I encourage you to watch this 5, but 10 is really suggested. Now, the statement. No court has the legal authority to mandate support for non-biological children. Many of you are familiar with that. If you're referred to as an obligor, you know what that is. That's an order, right? To pay child support if you're the obligor. But they often have in their contracts, no court has the legal authority to mandate support for non-biological children. That is a misleading statement. Now, let's apply Taza doctrine to this statement. Why? Because the statement is very deceptive. The statement is misleading, and here's why. Typically, a court cannot order a person to pay child support for a child they are not biologically related to. But there's a catch-22 here. Unless there are specific circumstances like signing a parentality document, even if you're not the biological father. Once you sign that, you're an obligor. Don't do it. Acting as the child's primary caregiver, that means you could simply just have been with this woman, knowing that the child isn't yours, but because you've been providing, and if you and her break up, you become an obligor to pay child support. Now you see why channels as this, wait, there is no channels like this. Shout out to my good brother, Yusef L. Well, maybe one. My good brother, Yusef L. But besides that, it's just me and my good brother, Yusef L, man. Shout out to Texas and my good brother, Yusef. But nevertheless, so leave your comments, subscribe, and share. If you need help, reach out to me. I can help you. The contact information is below in the bio in this video. Okay, so unless there are specific circumstances like signing a parentality document, acting as a child primary caregiver, or being legally considered a child's de facto parent. What's a de facto? It's existing in fact, but it's not the biological parent. Through established legal agreements or actions. Many of you get caught up like that. Now, these entities are created by the state through birth certificates and exist in civil society that we call the public. It's very imperative to know the distinction between private and public. Get KAHANTAZADAQ's books now by clicking the link below or visiting www.kahantazadaq.net and order the books, all of them. So, as such, they are subjects, meaning slaves. Now, to the rules established by their creators, which is civil government. So this child support and child custody are applying to the slaves. How can you expatriate yourself from that by becoming a secured creditor? Men, on the other hand, as myself, I'm merely an aggrieved man. I didn't say angry. I said aggrieved. One to which some wrong has actually been done. So I am man. I men, on the other hand, are outside of their public. Now, you might think of the public as if it were a box that contains only legal fictions. Men, I men, live outside of that box. And we could call this box the matrix or the judicial system. KAHANTAZADAQ lives outside of the box. Most are trapped within the box and can't escape due to aphasia. Aphasia. Or cognitive dissonance. The issue is that criminal takes over when the civil didn't resolve the matter. So a child support, child custody could become criminal when you don't civilly resolve the matter. Why? Because you're civilitur mortis. So criminal takes over when civil didn't resolve the matter. If you could use demur, which is a different issue of law, right? You see, criminal is the government that comes in on the scene after the third party presumably has actually been damaged, and then the government just adds a criminal case to it. Well, the only way that you could actually substantially cause the criminal case to go away is to correct the civil liability. Do you understand? It's the civil liability which created the dishonor which gives rise to the criminal case. Rewind that. So you have to dispose of the substance of the civil infraction and correct that by way of a set-off restitution. How can I perform a set-off restitution? What exactly is that, KAHANTAZADAQ? It is a discharge, the ability that you have to discharge after becoming a secured creditor. Ludu, Win West, could use this method. It's in the books. They have the books, but they're not reading. So they're back and forth into the sewer, which is a system, right? Whatever it is, child support.
Don't take my baby. I'm at $13,000 a month. What more do you want from me? What more do you want from me? Oh my God.
Oh. You never gonna forget that shit, trust me.
Oh, you did. Nigga, I spent Christmas in jail.
Child support. Traffic, credit card debts, whatever it is, you have to come back and accept the criminal filing, because the criminal filing procedurally was there to make the government revenue, moolah. That's why they pass all these statutes to make revenue to sustain the Democratic Occupation Army, to protect the people and the land themselves. And the only way the army gains revenue in order to stay on the land to protect the people through their money source, which is the king's court. So after you resolve the civil issue, you've got to accept the criminal charges and you've got to be willing to pay the criminal proceedings. Well, I tell you, how you do that? You can't pay anything, right? You set off the alleged debt. Secured creditors, as KAHANTAZADAQ, set off the debt on the private account in order to give restitution to the government so that they could actually settle up and close the criminal case. Without this, little dude, without this, One West, your case is just going to continue rolling on. So first you have to sit off the civil, which gets rid of the substance behind the reason that the criminal action is there. Then you have to offer the court the set off for the monetary charges so that the government can build up their offer to maintain the army to keep us under the protection to cause the criminal case to go into the background. So, you do both of these things and it will go away. Now, I just said a mouthful. Debtors won't comprehend that, which is why I'm encouraging you to re-listen and get the books. Understand this. Overstand this. Understand this. That under contract law, wait, contract is law. Aha moment. And law is contract. Always argue, which is Latin for to make clear, the contract, which is the law. Contracts are dynamic. We can make a move. And if I can make a move, I can make a move in my favor. So if you don't have a contract, you had better create one. Because since Erie Railroad versus Tompkins, contracts became the law of the land. So understand that under contract law, if an offer is made and the other party puts in a counter offer, a conditional acceptance is always a counter offer, by the way, which resolves the matter in another manner. But nevertheless, if it resolves this same matter, then it's deemed under contract law that the original offer is no longer binding. It is withdrawn from the proceedings and the counter offer is on the table. Caught that, right? Excuse me. So remember, just like any motion or pleading in the last first out, you must have the last motion on the table, otherwise you're in deep crap. Because all these courts of maritime admiralty courts and these courts of non-record, these nisi prees court, they have no history mentally of the whole proceedings of the findings. They just go for what's on top. They go for the top document and they're doing whatever is on the top document. It's a non-record court because the record is what's on top. So if the other party puts in a motion, you had not just better object to that motion. Did you catch that, Jaidee? Did you catch that, Lil Dude? Did you catch that, Wim West? See, you had better not write a document in opposition to, excuse me, you had better write a document in opposition to that motion. You had better not just object. You'd better write a document in opposition to the motion, because if you're on their motion, on their premise, under public policy, then you are screwed. And that's the mild way of putting it. You've got to replace what they're asking for with your motion from the private side for remedy. Do you understand? On the private side. So that when you're in those proceedings, you're dealing with the motion that's actually on the top of their motion. Now, I'll provide an excellent way to understand any presentment that comes your way, be it a fine, summons, a warrant, order, any legal commercial presentment. This information that I'm about to provide you with applies for educational purposes. Get KAHANTAZADAQ's books and memorize this. Paste this into your memory bank and your notes for future reference. And pay attention and keep it in your notes. You can achieve a good basic understanding right here if you play this again and again like I've suggested. Whatever document comes to you, ready for this? Ready for this? NC, huh? Whatever document comes to you, if it's a letter, a motion, summons, whatever, KAHANTAZADAQ writes across it, accept it for value, return for value, for settlement and closure, on proof of claim that the process that has extended so far has not settled and closed this in favor of your client. That's what KAHANTAZADAQ writes. See, you see, when you send a letter, the game is like hot potato. No one wants to hold a hot potato, right? Whatever document, letter, you get, whoever holds that paper is responsible and the liable party on that process. So the idea in the hot potato is that the one stuck with the potato ends up in trouble. You don't want to hold the paper, because if you hold the paper, you hold the duty to respond and make the claim right. Do you follow me?
You didn't have nothing to do with nothing. She just got in my motherfucking business.
I just want my baby. And no one's listening because no one's in the courtroom. I'm not doing anything illegal. I'm not doing anything.
You see, an offer. Remember, it's always just an offer. It's just an offer. You see, an offer is a contract. Got that, careful? And the one party giving you an opportunity to achieve or do something. Doesn't matter how threatening it is. Oh, you may spend 2 years in prison. It's just an offer. What are you going to do with the offer? They're giving you an opportunity to be able to do something, to achieve something. What they are trying to do is solicit you to change you from a winning mode as a creditor into an accepted mode of being a debtor. They made you an offer by sending you the paper. It's just an opportunity. See, in contract law, sometimes the failure to respond timely is acceptance of that offer. I want to make that abundantly clear. By dishonor. So if you hold the paper, he's charging you with being a debtor by charging what he's really saying is, I want you to voluntarily accept this role. If you keep this paper, then you've accepted the offer and you've got to comply with it. If you reject the offer, that's dishonor also. So the only thing that you could actually do is accept it and pay it, or do a counter offer. There's only four doors that you could go through in any commercial presentment. The first two are dishonor. You acquiesce. You go silent to the offer. Dishonor. You lose. You argue. You argue they use a legal lease on you. You lose. You don't understand the language. Number three, you stay in honor. You accept it. You pay the offer. Or number four, 99% of the time for me, I conditionally accept their offer upon proof of claim. You stay in honor. 99% of the time for me is always conditional acceptance, which is always a counter offer. Now, under contract law, it says once a party counter offers, the original offer is removed from the table. If you accept it for value, their offer, which is conditional acceptance for value, it's not that you agree with it, but you're accepting the paperwork offer, but you're returning it with your counter offer with new conditions. Do you understand? Do you understand? Now, because you have accepted the offer and the counter offer, the terms of the original offer no longer applies. The terms of the counter offers applies. Contract law. Man, I love this stuff. He said, Tazadaq, what about child support? This is how you deal with it. You don't file the actual instrument. You file a notice of the instrument, which is why you're doing a UCC-1 without an exhibit. And if you do it properly on a UCC-1 with the Secretary of State in your state, and you do it appropriately, he's going to transfer the notice of it down to your county, and it's going to be a notice of lien file. Not the actual instrument. A UCC-1 is merely a notice of lien. The actual lien is the security agreement. Do you understand? Which would convey all your rights right back to the state again. Because if you give a notice of lien, aren't you keeping the lien private? Yes. Which means that the lien is in chambers. Isn't it? If the lien is in chambers, your lien is protected. Now, would you ever need to bring the lien in the chambers to the roll if necessary? You're probably not even going to have to do that. You just need to bring the public notice of the lien, and if anybody ever rebuts or dispute the actual lien itself, the document never has to appear If it has to appear, it can appear in chambers to protect your rights. Stop asking me, Tazadaq, do I need to bring in my UCC one in the court? Do I need to bring in my security agreement? You could give up your unalienable rights by either succumbing to the public procedure, or you could waive it and give it up by not talking about your issue in the merit and turn the conversation back to their issue on the merits. Now, when it comes to the merits of the public issue, the merits evidence has to go into the private side. Now, I might have went over your head with that. So when I say the private side, I mean it has to go into chambers. You can never bring any evidence to the merits of an issue in the public, or you have conveyed the substance of your claim to the public again. Do you understand, Ludu? Do you understand, Wim West? Do you understand, Jaidir? So always talk about your issue in question forms. Never talk about the issue in statement forms. He that is asking is as king. The king is operating from a sovereign capacity. No one tells the king what to do. That went over your head. Rewind it. Play it back. Always submit your questions in the form. Always submit your question form. Never make statements, right? Never make statements. Private hearing officers and chambers is who's going to receive KAHANTAZADAQ's presentment. Never in the public procedure. Never file with the clerk of the court on a public time stamp like Little Dude did, like Wim West is doing. When it comes to procedure, they're basically going to try to get you to give up honor to the general jurisdiction of the court under the public policy. Without qualifying your actions to protect your rights, and they're going to try to get you to accept a public benefit, like the bean. The dude, man, went and got a briefcase, and don't want to act like a creditor, and don't want to pay the briefcase when the briefcase was right there with you, which will come under either their insurance policy for public protection. Submit yourself to their statutes and jurisdiction like Little Dude did, like Wim West did. Accept the benefit of a public attorney, a lawyer, or what have you. You accept the benefits of the liability for funding and settling the account, or for setting up the bonds. And if you do any of those things, then you've just waived your unalienable rights, Little Dude, Wim West, to your claim, in which the robe will ignore everything that you've done, both in procedure and in your record. So once you do that, you can't come back and try to act as if you are a creditor. You a debtor. So just go ahead, be a good little debtor and pay your fine. Be a good little debtor and pay the fine. Make it go away. Stop. Oh man, I don't like that he talked to me. He told me to give him $500. Be a good little debtor and pay the damn fine, and it'll go away. Do you understand? Because you can't operate from the capacity of a creditor because you're not a creditor. You have to read these books and study this stuff and become a secured creditor to be a creditor. No time for, it's not a football. Stop pump faking. You dig? If you try to act like a creditor, the judge will ignore everything done, both in the procedure and in your record, and you will be liable under public policy and whatever merits of public claims, right? Or whether they have any value or reality to them or not. So you got to comprehend the procedures. Do you understand? If anyone wants to correct the legal title positions of their children and take away the legal title from the state, here is how. Now put some donations in the room. I'll wait. Let's get the donations up, you all. Now, I will explain for educational purposes only what needs to be done to bring forward your claim. This procedure is used in any commercial or legal matter, regardless as they're, however they're dealing with claims and counterclaims. Now, you know why the state makes you register your children, so that they can have legal control over them. This is only for those that are seeking the truth. If you want to come over here and argue and talk about how much of a good guru you are, shalom, peace. Two fingers. Have a nice day. Children are not born with applications. Application means the bank. For birth certificates, they're not born with that. Had there been an application for a birth certificate, then that is turned over to the state. The state would have prima facie legal title to the children, and the parents have nothing but a user's equitable claim for possession, as long as they obey with the rules of the state. Order in every issue of the corporate state. You have to obey with every order and issue of the corporate state. The application for the birth certificate qualifies a bona fide evidence, which is introduced into the court institution, and by those records properly handled, parents must show private title claim to the children's in terms of legal title and brought a counterclaim. None of the parents comprehend or are able or capable to comprehend what is actually being done here. So allow me to explain. So the state can then issue orders to take legal custody and control of the children under one very simple provision of law. Titles to the children have actually appeared to be abandoned by the parents. And because no one makes a claim for the title to the children under the rule of law, look it up, the rule of law, right? Presumptions, right? The state encheats all abandoned property and titles, which give the state pure authority to gather under its wings the children to be protected under the state, because they are legally abandoned by their parents when no claim is made. Key word, no claim is made. So what we're seeing here is under your proof of claim that if you cannot show a document of legal title, you have no substance. You have no substance. How do you think Julio got the W? He listens. Why is Will West not getting the W? He's not really listening. He's not devoting his time. So he could be a good little debtor and go ahead and keep playing by their rules. Or you could really bite down on your mouthpiece, burn the midnight oil, and learn this Tazadaq doctrine. Do you understand? Do you understand? So you don't have no substance, no standing in any hearing, in any tribunal, and you will not prevail to do what is right. Not only do you have to pay your debts, but to do what is right, if you're going to prevail, you have to got to make a claim in their system. Otherwise, the failure to state a claim upon which relief can be granted applies to you, and it means that you have no claim and no standing. So get the hell out of my court. It's what the robe's going to tell you. The court of the tribunal will not listen to anything that you do, Will West, or little dude. So you got to go and get a briefcase. So what is a claim, KAHANTAZADAQ? What the heck are you talking about, man? Tell me. Put some donations in the room, and I will. I'll wait. Pause. But this is good, right? See, it's called right knowledge. So what is a claim? A claim is evidence of a legal title. In order to have a legal title, and if the property in question, this case being your sons and your daughters that they refer to as children, is involved in some kind of trust proceedings and some document memorializing that document exists, the birth certificate, right? And if the original document memorializing the trust is recorded, that they call register, right, in the public. The public has the legal title. Why? Because they have the birth certificate to the property that was once yours, which is your sons and your daughters. So in order to assert a claim on that property, you have to do something to remove that document of title from the public registry, replacing that with a notice of claim against the same property based on the fact that you can actually now show that you have inverted that trust and taken that trustee position away from the public government, and you assume position a private trustee over the property, which is your sons and daughters that they call children, assuming legal title. Do you understand? That is how it's done. And so with that, I'm going to bring this to an end. I will now open it up for you to leave comments and ask your questions, and I shall entertain them to the best of my ability. I am KAHANTAZADAQ, a spokesman for men and women that love them, and I'm helping men fight the good fight with right knowledge of child support and child custody. If you are a distressed father and you need help, reach out to me now. I'm KAHANTAZADAQ, and I'll prove this message. Shalom. Peace. To Fankus.
I'm one of the many men who've actually been deprived of rights as fathers. Too often, custody is granted to mothers even when the father is the better parent, in such cases as mine. This personal experience has led me to call for a class action lawsuit against family court for violation of men's rights in child support and custody orders. The current system is biased against men and does not always act in the best interest of the child or respect the rights of the fathers. According to research centers such as Pew Research, fathers are significantly less likely than mothers to be living with their children, and therefore this disparity means men are more likely to pay child support and not have custody. Moreover, it has actually been observed that men are often burdened with unfair child support and child custody orders. Stand up, do something now, sign the petition below. KAHANTAZADAQ.